What's up, Giants? This is the Redwood Sports Podcast, back at it again. I'm here with my boy,
Logan First.
And I'm Chris Lee. You know, Logan, we had an exciting week of MCAL playoffs, didn't we?
You know, it was a great week of MCAL playoffs. On Wednesday, we had boys and girls basketball, two victories for Redwood, and they're both playing the MCAL championship. Tonight, Redwood boys basketball plays. Make sure to be there and support Giants. Wow. And tomorrow, Chris, girls basketball plays. He almost interrupted me, didn't he? All right, Chris, what else do we have besides basketball?
Redwood boys soccer has been off to a hot season. They ended undefeated, and they had a nice little playoff win on Thursday. Wow, they'll be playing Saturday at Centerfield at 3 p.m. Be sure to support them in the championship. Also, the girls soccer team has been doing amazing. They had another playoff win on Thursday, and will also be playing at Centerfield 6:30 on Saturday. Be there to support.
Wow, Chris, that was amazing information. Chris, we also have another game this weekend, very important game. You might have heard about it.
Is it MCALS?
What is it? I don't think it's Redwood related, actually, Chris.
It's the Sunday Bowl.
Sunday Bowl. That's not what it's called.
Sunday Super Bowl, right?
Yes, it's the Super Bowl. It's a big game, Chris. What are your predictions?
You know, I've actually got a 5-leg parlay on this game, if you can believe it. I've got Trent Williams, 2 blocks. McCaffrey, 239 rushing yards, 2 total touchdowns. Let's see what else. We've got Brandon Ayuk, 23 passing yards, 2 catches. And last, Patrick Mahomes, 23 passing yards.
Wow, quite an interesting parlay, Chris. I don't know, you kind of lack a little bit of sports knowledge, but it's okay.
I know, ball.
For me, you know, I got the Niners winning this. You know, it's been a big season for both these teams, the Chiefs and the Niners. The Niners were number 1 seed, Chiefs were number 3 seed. I really think Purdy's going to cook in the second half, dice up that Chiefs defense,
absolutely,
really get the ball rolling to his stars, Deebo Samuel, George Kittle, and ultimately the Niners are going to come up with a victory. Chris, there's also another thing I want to ask you about this game. What are the chances of a halftime Travis Kelce proposal to Taylor Swift?
Well, that's pretty big. I'm going to have to take the under on that, Logan. You know, there's one man, I believe, that's standing in the middle of that. And if there's anyone who can break up a marriage like that, it's gotta be our boy, Mr. Redwood.
Back to the air, Purdy looking end zone. Brandon Ayuk, his second touchdown. Second down and short here. Purdy has one-on-one. George Kittle, goodbye! He found a touchdown! Security blanket for him. Saw you here. He's got it! He beats it! He makes it the distance!
Now is the perfect time. We can dim the lights just to make it like in the night.
What a poetic video right there, Chris. Brock Purdy should ball this weekend.
What a just like a steady, humble guy.
I just love
him. So amazing.
All right, Redwood and Giants, thank you for watching. Good luck this weekend.
Absolutely. Have a good day. I think we could have just cut where you were.
All right, we'll just take a bunch and Sam can just deal with it.
Yeah. Sam, are you watching all of this?
Hey Giants, I'm Barrett.
And I'm Monica.
And welcome back to season 13, episode 17 of Redwood TV.
Seniors, if you're interested in taking a gap year, come to the Gap Year Fair in the Little Theater later this February.
Giants, we are so excited to celebrate Red Fest with you, which is next Friday. Enjoy some live music on the South Lawn, bring some money for food vendors, and spread the love.
Seniors, if you want to design a flag to be raised and waved at a graduation, submit it here.
Seniors, make sure to fill out your graduation form, which was sent to your email by today. And now for a segment.
Welcome back to the Slam Redwood High School segment on Black History this month of February. Today, we will travel back in time from the Harlem Renaissance to the 1970s to study early African American art. In the 1920s and 30s, the rise of Black Renaissance and new Negro movement brought the Black arts to an international stage. Members of the armed forces, such as James Reese Europe, and artists, such as Langston Hughes, Josephine Baker, and Lois Mallow Jones, brought Black culture and Black American aesthetics internationally, and Black culture began its ascent to becoming a dominant cultural movement in the world. In addition to the Harlem Renaissance, Today, we recognize the cities like Los Angeles, Chicago, New York, and New Orleans. They were home to many Black artists. The 1960s continued this thread through the cultural evolution known as the Black Arts Movement, where artists covered issues such as pride in one's heritage and established art galleries and museum exhibitions to show their own work, as well as publications such as Black Art. This period brought us artists such as Alvin Ailey, Judith Jamison, Amiri Baraka, Nikki Giovanni, and Sonia Sanchez. The movement would not have been as impactful without the influences from the broader Black world, especially the Negritude movement and the writings of Frantz Fanon. In 1973, in the Bronx, New York Black musicians started a new genre of music called hip-hop, which comprises five foundational elements: DJing, MCing, graffiti, breakdancing, and beatboxing. Some significant hip-hop artists that pushed the boundaries during this time are DJ Kool Herc and Kok La Rock. They are even considered the godfathers of hip-hop today. Hip-hop performers also used technological equipment such as turntables, synthesizers, drum machines, and samplers to make their songs. Since then, hip-hop has continued to be a pivotal force in political, social, and cultural spaces, and was a medium where issues such as racial violence, sexism, economic disinvestment, and others took the forefront.
Hey Hayden, are you going to the game tonight?
Yeah, of course I'm going to the game.
Who are you going with?
The Wood!
Do you love going to sports games and getting spirited?
Get involved and join the Woods!
Hey Redwood, and welcome back to the club segment of Redwood TV. This week's club is going to be Poetry Club. Let's go take a look. Hi, can you please state your name?
Grace Scareman.
I'm Jonathan.
Brooke Ellington.
How long have you been a part of Poetry Club?
I've been a part of Poetry Club since this year, so it's been about 3 weeks now.
Forever.
And can you please tell us what your role in Poetry Club is?
I'm the current president of Poetry Club.
What's your favorite part about Poetry Club?
I like it when everyone comes and shares the poems they found, and they are really awesome.
My favorite part of Poetry Club is just being able to like get together with some friends and kind of do a fun like creative exercise and just be able to do something kind of different in the day that's not just like sitting down during a lecture.
And what do you do in Poetry Club?
Our primary emphasis this semester is on poetry composition and recitation.
Can you explain a little bit about that? Like what does that mean?
Okay, so kind of writing our own original works is like a big focus, of course, like writing your own poetry. And then our second kind of like focus is recitation, like I mentioned. You know, kind of historically, right? So poetry was communicated through reciting it, and that's a huge skill, memorizing, reciting. And that also, I think, encourages people to kind of gain confidence in their own skills and then kind of gaining that confidence.
Awesome, perfect, thank you.
Giants, the California Scholarship Federation application is due today.
Seniors, remember to fill out the senior superlative form, which can be found on the Class of 2024 Instagram.
And a huge congratulations to Redwood Epic Drama's production of The Farm, which won gold at the regional Sacramento Linnea Festival competition.
Giants, are you interested in doing some yoga? Well, there is a yoga class in the small gym on February 28th during SMART.
We love your jerseys. Make sure to be ready for the Spirit Days next week for Redfest.
This is Redwood TV.